Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Sunday, SpaceX launched the SDA Tranche 0 Flight 1 mission successfully on a Falcon 9 rocket.
1, ignition, and liftoff of SDA. Go SDA, go Falcon.
Vehicles pitching downrange.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1075, then landed successfully for the second time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
Stage 1 landing burn.
And the landing burn has begun. Let's watch as Falcon 9 touches down on Landing Zone 4.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And a great view. Falcon 9 has touched down on Landing Zone 4, and there you can see it standing tall right there on your screen. This was the second launch and landing for the specific booster and our 183rd overall successful recovery of an orbital class rocket, and that includes both Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy first stage landings.
We can still hopefully expect another mission to launch this week. The Intelsat 40E and Tempo mission is still scheduled for Friday 7th at 4:29 a.m. UTC or 12:29 a.m. EDT. I wanted to share this cool tweet posted of two drone ships passing by each other. One is bringing a booster back from a mission and the other is heading out to support another mission. Jonathan McDowell posted a tweet related to satellites launched on a SpaceX transporter mission last year. He said four DoD satellites launched on the Transporter 3 mission in January 2022 are suspected to have been military versions of the Starlink bus. Three of them began orbit lowering in January 2023 and re-entered on April 1st to 2nd. Heading to Boca Chica, scaffolding was seen being removed from the orbital launch mount. There have been multiple bits of information all over the place indicating when we could potentially see the Starship flight test. There have been a bunch of websites updating their no earlier than launch date for the orbital flight test as April 10th. In addition to that, whilst it doesn't specifically say Starship, there are imaging placeholders for NASA's WB-57 plane. This plane has been sent out previously for Starship suborbital flights, so these placeholders could be related to the Starship launch. The placeholder dates are for April 10th and April 11th. There was also this document posted on the FAA website related to air traffic control. It has a date of April 10th for the Starship launch with a backup of April 11th. Nothing is definitive without the FAA launch license, but it's exciting nonetheless. There was another tweet posted, this one from Christian Davenport. He said, for the SpaceX Starship launch attempt, 410 is possible, I'm told. The FAA safety evaluation is complete, the legal review is underway, but there is an environmental issue to close out. That may or may not get resolved by Monday, but it sounds like the license is almost there. There are some tweets I want to share from Eric Berger. The first says, here's a short thread on three things I think I know about Starship's orbital flight attempt. 1. Elon has been publicly pessimistic about launch dates of late, and April 10th is semi-real. The next tweet he posted says, 2, I believe a launch license is forthcoming. The real risk I have heard about is a last minute civil lawsuit. In this scenario, the FAA issues the license and a civil suit is immediately filed for environmental reasons. It is possible a judge would issue a temporary injunction. Finally, he also posted, 3, SpaceX is very close to being ready technically. They will make a decision soon about whether they are ready to proceed with the launch or need to step back for a few more days to review data ahead of the attempt. But barring legal action, this thing is happening this month. Eric Berger also posted a tweet related to the potential launch next week. He said, for what it's worth, SpaceX has told NASA it is targeting April 10th with backup days on April 11th and 12th for the Starship orbital flight test. None of this is official without a launch license and the usual caveats apply. Unfortunately, there was another tweet posted today indicating we may have to wait a little longer than next week for the launch. The tweet says SpaceX completed stacking of its Starship vehicle onto the Super Heavy booster this morning. Unfortunately, two sources say April 10th is no longer on the table as a launch date. As we saw last video, Starship 24 was rolled back to the launch site for hopefully the final full stack. As you saw in the tweet just now, Starship 24 has now been restacked atop Booster 7 prior to the first Starship flight. The piece of Starship 28 in the high bay was seen being rotated. The grid fins on Booster 7 were seen being tested recently. SpaceX have performed some more testing of the Booster 7 prototype as we get closer to launch. Taking a look at the Roden Beach closures, SpaceX have a possible closure still for today, Wednesday 5th. In addition to that possible closure today, there are possible closures for next week with Monday 10th, Tuesday 11th and Wednesday 12th. As always, I have to say thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.